Hello everyone. In the last class, I explained how to draw shear force and bending momentum using ILD for a single wheel load. But today we will see how to draw ILD for shear force and bending moment for the two point loads or two wheel loads. Okay. So here the problem is given like this: two point loads of 100 kN and 50 kN spaced 1 meter apart cross a girder of span 8 meter from left to right with the 50 kN load leading. Draw the influence line for shear force and bending moment and find the value of maximum shear force and maximum bending moment at section 3 meter from the left hand support. This is the problem given. What we have to do, we have to draw ILD for shear force and bending moment and then find maximum shear force and bending moment. So first step here, this loads are moving from left to right, so what is that? This is the first position leading load and this is the second load. So now here it is given that 50 kN load is leading. So 50 kN load is leading two loads, 100. So this is the second point and this is the first point. So this is W1, this is W2, 1 meter apart. Okay. Now what we have to do, if it is a single load, directly you place that load at the section and find the ordinate value and multiply that ordinate value with the load, you will get the answer. But here two loads are there, so which load we have to place at the section and which load gives the maximum shear force and bending moment, that we have to check. So for that, what we will do, first consider the case 1 or trial 1. Place first load, 50 kN load at the section. Okay, so draw simply supported beam. This is just a loading condition, loading distribution of load. This loading system, you have to place it on the simply supported beam. Okay, so I draw simply supported beam AB of span 8 meter. It is given span of 8 meter here. The span is 8 meter. So simply supported beam AB of span 8 meter and 50 kN load leading. I place this loading system here and this is 1 meter apart. The distance between these two loads is 1 meter. Now they have asked to find bending moment and shear force at a section 3 meter. So section is located at a distance of 3 meter from the left end. So from A, the section is located at a distance of 3 meter. So what is the remaining distance? Remaining distance is 5 meter. So now first case we'll consider, place 50 kN load at the section. So 50 kN load is here. So where 100 comes, it is behind that. So 100 kN load comes here, that is 1 meter apart. So total distance is 3 meter. So this is 1, so this is 2 meter. Okay, then usual method, find ILD for shear force. What you have to do, first consider left portion AX, means unit load is in between A and X. Here always, I told in earlier classes also, you have to assume one unit load which is moving from A to B or B to A. In this case, it is left to right, so it is moving from A to B. So now that unit load is in between the portion A and X, that is your assumption. Okay, so what is shear force at X? I said in the last class also, if unit load is in this side, you consider the other side. So now unit load is between AX, so I consider shear force at X this side, so that is minus RB. What is RB? RB is Y by L. So shear force at X is minus Y by L. Now find at different points. First point is at A. What is at A? It is Y is equal to 0. If you substitute, you will get VA is equal to 0. Next point, here one point is there because the loading position is there here. So that is Y is equal to 2. So substitute, you will get this answer, minus 0.25. Next, at X, Y is equal to 3. So this is minus 0.38. Okay, done. This portion is done. Go to the next portion. That is what? X and B. So assume unit load is now between X and B, not here. Okay. So what is now shear force at X? A unit load is here. So I consider this side. What is that? Plus RA. So RA is equal to L minus Y divided by L. So Now, at different points, you have to find. Now, you have to start from here because already unit load reached till here. Now, it is moving from here to here. So, at x, y is equal to 3. So, substitute in this equation, you get 0.62. Next point, here only, last point. At y is equal to 8. And again, you get VB is equal to, substitute if you get VB is equal to 0. Over. Now draw this, transfer these points to the diagram. So what is that? At A it is 0, at A 0, at C minus 0.25, so below the line 0.25 minus 0.25, and next point is at the section it is 0.38. Okay, minus. Next, consider right portion XB. Here at X it is plus 0.62, plus 0.62 and 0. And always when you add this ordinate values at the section, it should be equal to 1. So this is now equal to 1. Over. Next, find bending moment. ILD for bending moment. What you have to consider now? Now here that load should be multiplied by the perpendicular distance. So now you again you consider this left portion AX. So unit load is in between A and X now. So what is bending moment at X? Bending moment at X is unit load is here. So I consider from this side. So bending moment at X is RB into 5. So what is RB? RB is equal to Y divided by L into 5. So at different points at A, what is Y? Y is equal to 0. So if you substitute in this, you get MA is equal to 0. Next point at C, Y is equal to 2. So MC is equal to 1.25. Substitute in this equation. Next at X, Y is equal to 3. At X, Y is equal to 3. So MX is 1.88. Over left portion. Next, go to the right portion. Means unit load is now in between X and B. Unit load is here. Okay. So now, what is bending moment at X? Bending moment at X. Unit load is here. I consider this side. What is that? RA into 3. What is RA? RA is L minus Y divided by L into 3. Now substitute at different points. First point you have to start from here at X. So what is that? X, Y is equal to 3. So MX is 1.88. Next at B, Y is equal to full distance. So MB is equal to 0. So draw ILD now at A 0 and at C it is 1.25, and at X it is 1.88. Next portion, right portion. Again at X it is 1.88. Next, no other points, directly B, that is 0. So always plus. Now here you again I'm telling you, at the section from both the left side and right side you have to get the same answer. Okay, done. Next, you do usual method. What is that? Maximum shear force is equal to load into this distance. For shear force, take it from ILD of shear force, and for bending moment, take values from bending moment diagram. ILD for bending moment. So first we'll consider shear force. See again, now here there is a difference. Now load is at the section. When the load is at the section, you will have two values. Maximum positive shear force also, maximum negative shear force also. So that you have to remember. Okay, if the load is at the section, you have both maximum positive shear force and maximum negative shear force. So now first we'll see what is maximum positive shear force. What is that? Now positive shear force means you have to take a positive value at the section. So maximum positive shear force is 100 into minus 0.25, 100 into minus 0.25 plus 50 into 0.62 positive shear force. This is common. Anyhow, you have to take. But in this, either any one of you have to take. If it is positive, take positive value. If it is negative, take negative value. Okay. So positive shear force is equal to 100 into minus 0.25 plus 50 into 0.62. So you get one answer. Next, total negative shear force, 100 into minus 0.25 plus 50 into minus 0.38. negative value you have to take. So minus 0.3, you get one answer. Next, total bending moment. What you have to do? Take it from bending moment diagram. 100 into 1.25 plus 50 into 1.88. You get one answer. Okay, this is the first trial you have to do. You're checking now what is the maximum shear force by placing 50 kilonewton load at the section. Next possibility is what? Place 100 kilonewton load at the section and repeat the same thing whatever you have done for the first trial. Same thing you have to do. Now see. Place 100 kilonewton load at the section. Now you have to place this 100 kilonewton load at the section. Okay, so what happens now? 50 kilonewton comes this side because it is leading load. So that comes on the right side now. So now AX there is no load, XP there is this 50 kilonewton load. See the difference here, that is 100 kilonewton load was here on left side. Now 100 kilonewton load is at the section, so 50 kilonewton load comes on the right side. Okay, so that is the difference. Then everything is same. So now section is here at a distance 3 meter from left end, and this is so 5 meter. Now again do the same procedure. ILD left portion, that is minus RP. Find a different point. You know already at A it is 0, and at the section already you calculated, so no need to calculate again. That is same because the distance is same, right? It is at A to X it is 3 meter, so it is 0.38 and 0.62 only. No need to do, but still I have shown if you get confused. Okay, you no need to do, you can directly write. Next, only this value you have to find. At D, what is Y? Y is equal to 3 plus 1, 4. 4. So this is on right side. Right side means you have to consider unit load is on right side now, yeah, this portion. So take it, shear force is this side, RA. So L minus Y. Substitute, you get this ordinate value, 0.5. Then draw the diagram. Next, same thing, bending moment also. Again, this is same. You have to get same thing, bending moment at the section same. This is not there. You have to calculate now for this point. What is for this? That is on right side. Means unit load is on the right side now. So, you have to consider that bending moment from this side. So, this is already you know what is 1.88. Next, consider the next portion, right portion. So that is RA into 3, this distance, RA into 3. So RA is L minus Y divided by L into 3. Okay, bending moment. So substitute a different point, same method you get. Then again find total shear force, negative and positive both are there because load is at the section. So first negative shear force is, first we'll take positive. So maximum total positive shear force is 100 into 0.62 plus 50 into 0.5. So 100 into 0.62 plus 50 into 0.5. Next, negative. Here it is negative. I have not marked. Just consider this is minus. So next, negative shear force. 100 into minus 0.38 plus 50 into 0.5. Right. Then maximum bending moment. 100 into 1.88 plus 50 into 1.55. So you get this answer. Now what you have to do? Now you have two sets of values, both positive, negative and bending moment. You compare both and which is the maximum? That is maximum positive shear force, maximum negative shear force and maximum bending moment. See here, first trial, what is total positive shear force is 6 and here it is 87. So which is maximum? 87. So maximum positive shear force is 87 kilonewton. Next, maximum negative shear force, here it is minus 44 and here it is minus 13. So neglect that sign, both are minus. So which is maximum? That is 44. So take 44. Then maximum bending moment, here 219 kilonewton meter, here 263 kilonewton meter, which is maximum 263. So take this. So this is maximum positive shear force is 87, maximum negative shear force is 44 kilonewton, maximum bending moment is 263 kilonewton meter. So this is the way to find draw ILD for shear force and bending moment when it is subjected to two wheel load. So what you have to do, first consider one load at the section, draw ILD for shear force and bending moment, find shear force and bending moment value. Next, place other load at the section, find the load and compare. Finally, you compare which is the maximum. That's it. Thank you.